Welcome viewers. In this video, we will be discussing about a spectrofluorimeter. This instrument is used to study fluorescence emitted by an analyte. The principle of spectrofluorimeter is it uses the fluorescence produced by the analyte to perform the qualitative and quantitative analysis on it. The fluorescence emitted by a particular analyte has a specific wavelength associated with it, and the amount of emissions gives one the quantitative measure of the analyte. Let us start with the construction. The first component of the spectrofluorimeter is the light source. The lamp or the light sources that can be used include xenon lamps, high-pressure mercury vapor lamps, lasers, or even LEDs. The laser and LEDs have a very specific wavelength. The next component in the spectrofluorimeter is the exciter monochromator. This monochromator is placed between the light source and the cuvette which holds the sample. The exciter monochromator can be a prism monochromator or a diffraction grating. The sample under test is placed in the sample holder. A transmission detector like a PMT measures the transmitted light from the sample. The next component is the analyzer monochromator. It is placed perpendicular to the incident light beam. The analyzer monochromator is also a prism monochromator or a diffraction grating. The next component is the fluorescence detector, which is generally a PMT. PMT is used as even slightest radiations or low intensity radiations are easily measured by them. Coming to working, we can see that the light from the light source passes through an exciter monochromator. Here, only the required wavelength of light passes through the exit slit. This incident light is absorbed by the sample or the analyte. The remaining light gets transmitted and falls on the transmission detector. The sample gets excited by the incident radiation. The phenomena of fluorescence takes place, and fluorescence of a particular wavelength is emitted by the sample. This emitted radiation is made to pass through analyzer monochromator, which filters out any stray light mixed with fluorescent radiations. Once the fluorescence exits the analyzer monochromator, its intensity is measured by the detector, which is generally a PMT. The wavelength of fluorescence is very specific and depends upon the molecules or electrons present in the sample. Thus, one can identify the compounds present in the analyte by studying the fluorescence wavelength. The intensity of fluorescence is dependent on the number of a particular molecule or electrons being present in the sample. Thus, intensity helps in performing quantitative analysis of the sample. This was the working of the spectrofluorimeter. Now, the advantage of using a spectrofluorimeter is greater sensitivity is achievable since background signal is zero when compared to absorption measurements. Differences in wavelengths between incident and emitted light helps to discriminate between substances having similar absorption characteristics. Hope you have learnt a bit about spectrofluorimeter from this video. Subscribe to the channel to stay tuned for such more videos. And do not forget to follow our Instagram page and Facebook page. Stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.